Part of the benefits of being in high school is having fun in inter-school sports and tournaments and so on. There's this character that we will never forget as far as our stay in school is concerned. I think the years between 1993 and 1996. Some guys coming from Western Kenya will know there's a character who was called Bill. This guy was phenomenal. As in, this guy who'll play more than three, four disciplines in the same tournament. There used to be tournaments where we'll have hockey, we'll have basketball, we'll have handball, all at the same day. And this guy would be representing his school in all those disciplines. He was multi-talented, he was a genius. Basically, he was dexterous in all that stuff. Bill play hockey, get out of the hockey pitch and go play basketball, represent his team and does well, and then go play handball, you guy. Anyway, in this episode, we want to talk about one of the reasons as to why we do not expend our God-given potential, and it's going to be an interesting one. You want to stay tuned.
Welcome to the Life Signatures Podcast with Lawrence Namale. Lawrence is a life coach, author, and keynote speaker who loves to tackle different topics on purpose, productivity, and resilience. His mission in life is to awaken all your boundless possibilities available in you. Life Signatures Podcast is dedicated to bring to reality every single person who knows that deep down in their gut, there's got to be more to life than this. And now, here is your host, Lawrence Namale.
When I tell you a story, the story about Bill, what comes to your mind? Do you feel like this guy was over talented and he would have shared some of his gifts and his talents with you? I mean, do you feel like he was overcompensated in terms of gifts and talents? That's the question that we need to answer today. Now, is it a good thing that he had that, or is it a bad thing that he had that, and so on and so forth? That's the question that we need to discuss today and find out. What exactly is it that is a problem in people deploying their God-given potential? And we've said that there are several reasons. One, start a school. I've explained that in the previous episodes. Two, lack of purpose. I've also explained that in the previous episodes. If you don't have purpose, guess what? You're not going to fulfill your potential, because potential and purpose are connected to the hip. Three, ignorance. And I've said very many times that we have this generation and this technological generation where we know very many things at the click of the mouse. But guess what? We are the most ignorant in terms of our gifts and talents and our potential. The previous generations, at least those ones, they could push themselves to, you know, discover what those are. But today, with all this knowledge and so on and so forth, we are the most ignorant, the most purposeless of generations. The third reason, the fourth reason as to why, we discussed that yesterday, as to why people do not exploit their God-given talent and their potential to exploit it. It is godlessness. Why? Because if you know that there is a God and is going to require of you, going to give an account of the things that you are given, to whom much is given, much is going to be required, you're going to be circumspect about the dealings that you have with your potential. You're going to want to fulfill that potential. You're going to want to do it as best as you can to please your master, so to speak. And I know that doesn't sound good for some people, but I'm afraid that's just the way it is. But today I want us to discuss one thing. The reason as to why people do not fulfill their God-given potential is something that I call incongruence. Now, let's park Bill for a minute and go to this scripture that Christians normally use for very many times. Christians normally console themselves with the fact that, quote unquote, I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. One of the things that we need to realize that is already written in Scripture. But the other thing that we need to realize is that Scripture is always going to be interpreted in context. There is before the text, there is the text, there is after the text, and then there is the general historical background through which that text was written. So when you say you can do all things through Christ who strengthens you, it begs the question, if you can do all things, why would you be gifted in one particular thing and not be gifted in another? And guess what? The person who gave you that particular gift and did not give you the other is the one that you're saying you can do all things through him. You see, this thing of doing all things through Christ, it came like this. Paul the Apostle was writing to people. He was talking about, I know how to live without and I know how to live in abundance. And he said, either way, I am okay and therefore I can do all things through Christ. He wasn't saying that Lawrence can become a doctor, and by the way, I hate blood and syringes and I hate hospitals. He wasn't saying that Lawrence can become a doctor, he can become a speaker, he can become a president. Okay, I can become a president if I want. He wasn't talking about all that stuff. All right? So this idea of you not focusing on your potential and wanting to meddle in as many things as possible is one of the reasons as to why you're not fulfilling your God-given potential. You are here, you're trying this, you are there. And I know, by the way, there's this period of excavation and exploration, which is a beautiful period where we can try this and try that. And I remember a very embarrassing thing in primary school. In primary school, I used to see two kinds of guys. First of all, there were guys who used to dance, a dance group, all right? And this dance group always had the privilege of going to trips and so on and so forth. And in the back of my mind, I always wanted to go for a trip. And I figured, the only way you're going to do this trip is when you get into the dance group. And guess what? I went into this dance group and where they were practicing in the morning and so on and so forth. And I tried to join and I tried to dance and they chased me. I mean, it was very embarrassing. I was trying dancing. And by the way, let me tell you something. I do not have the skill and the talent of dancing. I lack coordination. Sometimes I dance off beat and I don't love dancing at all. Anyway, the other thing was gymnastics. I saw guys doing gymnastics. One of my cousins was also in there. And they also, the gymnasts, when they do the gymnastics and so on, so they will do what? They would go for trips. And I thought, dancing did not work. Let me go for gymnastics. And I went there and they also chased me because I was supposed to do some kind of act and I just couldn't. And the teacher chased me and guys laughed. It was very extremely embarrassing. But anyway, I was exploring. But this guy who was trying to do dancing, this guy who was trying to do gymnastics, he's gifted with writing and reading and speaking. You get my point? So anyway, there's this point where you can explore and sometimes it's very obvious some things that just don't fit. Some things we are interested in. By the way, today if I told someone to choose any talent that they wanted, very many people will choose sports in terms of football and so on, that I can be able to earn $200,000. I mean, £200,000, you guy, per week. Huh? And people go in there. So Bill... Let's go back to Bill. Bill was gifted and he was talented in all these disciplines. But the problem with Bill is that he was incongruent. And that is one of the biggest problems that we have in life. Being incongruent. What does being incongruent mean? It means you are all over the place. A friend of mine was asking me some years back. He said, I can play the guitar. I can sing, I write some songs, I can speak, I can write books. I'm kind of an all-rounded guy in this kind of these arts. I can play volleyball, I can swim. And he was asking, what's the problem there? Now, there is no problem at all in those things. My problem is that we only have one life. You only have one life and you better be congruent with one thing or few things, fewer things, that means that you've got to be focused on something that works. If you are gifted in terms of singing, let us know you as a singer. And of course, you can sing, but you can also write and you can also speak. Can you choose a dominant gift and a dominant talent and focus on it and lean into it? And if these others can support at some point in time, that's okay. But can you lean into one of those dominant disciplines? Like now, we don't know where Bill is. With all those gifts and those talents, we do not know where Bill is. He is not anywhere in the sports arena. I don't know if he was good in the academics arena also. I'm told he was also good. But we don't know where he is with those things. Can you say that his potential was fulfilled, where he was just doing about everything? Well, how about Bill chooses, let's say, basketball and sticks there so that when he plays basketball, he gives 100% focus on it. And then when the game is through, he rests. All right, he rests and he recuperates and he becomes sharper and sharper. Bill was incongruent. That's one of the reasons as to why people do not maximize their potential. Bill was special in his gifting. At the second time games, he will finish hockey match, dash to the basketball court, play without resting. But today is nowhere. Interestingly, potential is developed to the degree that you realize your gifts, your skills, your talents, but you also deploy them in a focused and consistent manner. Congruence comes with focus and consistency. If there is no focus, there is no consistency, there is not going to be congruency. You're gonna be helter skelter all over the place. You're gonna be 1 inch deep and 1,000 miles wide, stretched too thin. You cannot accomplish nothing. So find congruency in being consistent. Find congruency in being focused. It is, I nearly said Muhammad Ali, but it is actually Bruce Lee who say that, "I don't fear the guy who has practiced 10,000 kicks once, but I fear the guy who has practiced one kick 10,000 times." That's the thing with congruency. Find one thing, stick with it, focus on it, stay with it, be known by it. When it is mentioned, your name comes up. When your name comes up, it's also mentioned. That's what congruence is all about. If we are doing a million things all at the same time, we don't have time to develop each and every one of them. We don't. We just average. You know, there are different levels of competence. There is when someone is totally incompetent, they're just starting, the hint of the gift and the talent and the potential is there. And then when they start practicing and they get a coach and they get a mentor, they become competent. And then when they continue practicing and so on and so forth, they become an expert, they become a master, they become a virtuoso, they become a genius. They have this godly ability, matchless ability to do stuff. But you can't get to matchless ability if you're doing everything. This, you touch this, you leave it, you touch the other one, you leave it, you touch the other. You're lacking congruency in you. You cannot get to matchless ability if you lack congruence. So, did your potential to be deployed, you're going to be connected to it, one, and then you're going to be focused on it, two, and then you're going to be consistent with it, three. You cannot do that for several things. You can do that for just a few things, or for the most part, I would prefer you do it for one thing and see where it takes you. Tomorrow, we're going to discuss yet one more reason as to why people do not get to deploy their potential. But until then, bye-bye. A special shout out to my mentor, Jeffrey Howard of Visionary Business University, found at mastermindmentor.com, who has graciously provided me with the soundtrack and the introductory track to this podcast. Thank you, Jeff.
Thank you for listening to Life Signatures Radio. If you enjoyed today's show, subscribe to Life Signatures Radio on iTunes, Stitcher, or visit our website at lifesignatures.libsyn.com. Life Signatures Radio, fresh, clean, and inspiring.